Hello everybody and welcome here for a very short and unpolished video. I don't have much time. I'm heading tomorrow for Germany to play a concert with my colleague and friend Jan Weinhold. And today I have three instruments in our home. I don't know if that's the case next week. It's possible, but do not miss the opportunity. I just run over them with the camera handheld and present them very short to you. So there you have the three instruments, and I'll explain you in a few words why they are here. So you have my instrument, of course, you know that. And you probably will recognize, or some of you, or have seen the Beethoven, which sonata was it? The F minor opus 2 number 1 is played on this instrument, and the Mozart sonata B flat major, if I'm not mistaken, Kachelverzeichnis 333. My clavichord was back then at Joris' workshop for some adjustments. So very briefly, that is Joris Potvlieg's own instrument. I call it his big instrument because it's 12 centimeters longer than mine. For the rest, it's the same type of instrument. You will see, it's a little light here, but you will see the direction of the grain of the clavichord here, of the soundboard, is in the direction of the instrument. Here it's the opposite. It's more the Swedish construction, kind of experiment for him, I think, but also it's not an experiment, but an option. So we can go into detail, but that would make this video much longer, what the sound characteristics are of these two types of soundboard. You see the bridge, which has the original Saxon shape. Mine is actually a little bit off what concerning the shape of the bridge, but that's very technical. That instrument is actually like with all options of furniture. You see, my instrument is very sober. I wanted to have it like that, and it's also was something that my budget could allow. Also the name board. But if you see this instrument, of course, that's the instrument builder's instrument, and he wants to give light, so to say, to the capacities of his workshop. And it's really, really beautiful craftsmanship. And also the inner side of the instrument here is with veneer, finished with a small black, I think it's ebony list. So it's a very beautiful instrument. They are of the same family if you play on both instruments, and I know both of them very well. And they have their own typical aspect. This instrument, no wounded strings. What's that in English? So that's something that Joris really don't like to use. And this instrument, because it's longer, actually, you don't miss it. I don't miss it on my instrument either. I could ask him to do that, but I don't. So, but the bass, the lowest five notes here are more present than on my instrument. My instrument gains a little bit from bottom C because the scaling of the string there is actually longer on my instrument. Then you have here a little instrument from actually built by, and I have shared on Facebook, by Christopher Clark, 1978. And the master builder, I think we can call him like that, responded on Facebook, very nice, that it indeed was one of his first Paris instruments, sold to Patrick Collon, which is a great organ builder living in Brussels. He's a good friend of mine, 74 years old, building his last organ. But that is, he's saying, the last 10 years, I think, in Paris. And I visited him because we have some projects together. And he kindly lent me this instrument, which he has bought in 78. So it's for a long time. It's a copy from an instrument that is in the Russell collection. It's heavily fretted. But beautifully made, really, for that time, actually exceptional work. And we will make a video on this instrument. I would very much like to have some information from Christopher Clark, and maybe even an interview, wouldn't that be great? So that's actually in a nutshell these three instruments here. I'm standing in the middle of that, and that's really incredible. If I go around, I hope you don't get dizzy by doing that. That's actually amazing. And then this little clavichord is resting on the big Erard. So I'm feeling very rich, and I thought that's worth sharing with you. Anyway, see if the camera focuses on me. We'll do more on the little instrument later. Make some recordings on it, of course. What else have you taught? I think Sweelinck works fine on that instrument and other music of that time as well. So, a new thing that's coming up on the channel. Thanks for watching. See you later. Bye.